Hello everyone, in this video we will perform an activity from chapter 3rd class 10 science, metal and non-metal, and this is activity number 3.8. For this we required magnesium ribbon, a sulphur powder, a water, blue and red litmus, a china dish, a pair of tongs, spatula and a holder fitted with a test tube. In this activity we will burn these both sample and will collect their ash in separate test tube and then dissolve that ash, and then we will add in them the blue litmus or red litmus and observe the change. So let's perform this activity. So the first part of this activity, I have taken the magnesium ribbon here and I will heat it over the Bunsen flame, and then I will collect the ash of this magnesium ribbon. So magnesium react with oxygen and form magnesium oxide. It is a white dazzling flame here, so you can observe here. The white color ash is formed here. So this is the ash here, you can observe. A white color ash is formed in this case. Now I will dissolve this ash in water and observe its change with red litmus. So first of all, I will add a water into it. And then just dissolve this here. You can observe here. Now to this I will add a red litmus into it, and you can observe the change in color. So it is red in, initially it is red in color, but when it is completely react with it, it turns blue. You can observe here. So now it turns blue in color. So what we will perform, the second part of the activity, where we have to take this sulfur powder and we have to heat it over the flame. And then we have to collect these fumes in an inverted test tube. So I have taken here this test tube just like this. Now I am heating this sulfur over the flame, and then you can observe a fumes are obtained which I am collecting in this test tube. You can observe here. You can observe in the test tube fumes are collected in it. Now fumes are collected in it. You can observe here. Now fumes are collected in it. Now I will add water into it, water into this test tube, and will dissolve these fumes. And to this we will add a blue litmus, and then you can observe the change here. Now this blue litmus turn red in color. So I am adding here the blue litmus, which is turned red here. So what is the difference in both case? In case of sulfur, we form an oxide, sulfur oxide, when it dissolves in water, it is acidic in nature. Whereas in case of magnesium metal here, in case of magnesium metal, when we have heated it, it forms an oxide which is basic in nature because it turns red litmus blue. Now the question based on this activity 3.8, that is the product formed on burning of magnesium is acidic or basic. Now as we know, when magnesium is heated, it forms magnesium oxide, and when it is dissolved in water, it forms magnesium hydroxide, and because it turns red litmus blue, so what we can say? We can say that it is basic in nature. So the question here is that magnesium is acidic or basic. So magnesium oxide is basic in nature because it dissolves in water, form magnesium hydroxide, which turn red litmus blue. Now the same question for burning of sulfur powder. So on collecting that ash, when it dissolves in water, it turns, what is the nature of that product form is acidic or basic. So sulfur, when heated with oxygen, or we can say heated over the flame, it forms the sulfur oxide, and when it is dissolved in water and it is forming a acidic substance H2SO4, that is why it is very mild here. It is not a very strong acid here, because we are dissolving only the fumes of sulfur dioxide in water. And sulfur dioxide is acidic in nature because it turns blue litmus red here. So this activity is very much important on the fact that by this activity we have concluded that metal form a basic oxide and non-metal forms a acidic oxide. And how can you prove that oxide is basic or acidic? By just dissolving in water and then adding into it the red litmus or the blue litmus. So can you write the equation for these reactions? I have already written over. That is, magnesium reacts with oxygen and forming magnesium oxide. When it is dissolved in water, it forms magnesium hydroxide. Similarly, sulfur reacts with oxygen forming sulfur dioxide, and when it is dissolved in water, it forms an acidic. And the final conclusion, most non-metal produce acidic oxides when dissolved in water, and on the other hand, metal give rise to a basic oxide.